This is an example of how to take a higher order derivative. So the question here is find the third derivative of f at x equals x to the power of 5 plus 2x cubed minus x plus 4. So when we're finding a higher order derivative, we're basically taking a derivative multiple times. For this question, it says find the third derivative, so we're going to take the derivative 3 times. The notation we're going to use is f prime of x for the first derivative, f double prime of x for the second derivative, and f triple prime of x for the third derivative. So the first step is finding your first derivative. So before we do that, I'm just going to outline two of the rules that we're going to have to use in order to take the derivative. The first rule is when we have the derivative of x to the power of n. The derivative is going to be n times x to the power of n minus 1. So basically what you're doing is multiplying this n by the x and then subtracting 1 from the power. So for the second rule, it's going to be the derivative of a constant, which here, c represents a constant. So when we take the derivative, it's just going to be 0. So now that we have our two rules, we can start to take the derivative. So our first term is x to the power of 5. So here, 5 is going to be our n. So we can bring this 5 down and multiply it, and then subtract 1 from the 5. So we can see that's going to be 5x to the power of 4. For the next term, we have 2x cubed. The 2 here is not a constant, it's a coefficient. So what you can do is just take the derivative of x cubed, like you normally would, and then multiply it by 2. So the derivative of x cubed is 3x squared, because we bring this 3 down and then minus 1 from the power. So now we can multiply all of that by 2. So what we're actually going to get is plus 6x squared. So the next term we have minus x, so it doesn't look like we're going to have to use this first rule that we outlined, but we're actually going to, because when we have just x, it's actually x to the power of 1. So when we take the derivative of that using the power rule, we have 1 times x, and then minus 1 to the power. So it's just going to be 1 times x to the power of 0, and you have to remember here that when you have x to the power of 0, it is going to be 1. Anything to the power of 0 is just equal to 1. So here it's going to be 1 times 1, and then that is just 1. So this whole term is just going to turn into minus 1. So I'll just write down that rule here. So when you take the derivative of just x itself, it's always just going to be 1. And that's just something you can remember yourself, because that's always going to hold true. So for this last term, we have plus 4, and 4 is a constant. So here we use this rule. So when we take the derivative of a constant, we're just going to get 0. So you can add the plus 0 if you want, but you're not actually adding any terms that you may have to take another derivative of, because the derivative of 0 is just going to be 0. So you don't have to worry about adding it if you don't want to. So now we can take our second derivative. To find our second derivative, we're going to take the derivative of this first derivative that we just found. So starting with the first term, here we see that we have a coefficient again. So the derivative of x to the power of 4 is just 4x cubed. So when we multiply the 4 by the 5, we're going to get 20. So it'll be 20x cubed. For the second term, we also have a coefficient here. So the derivative of x squared is 2x. And when we multiply it by the 6, we're going to get plus 12x. And the derivative of minus 1 is just going to be 0 because it's a constant. So here we can find our third derivative. Our third derivative is what we're trying to find, so it's going to be our final answer. So when we're finding the third derivative, we're going to take the derivative of our second derivative. So when we take the derivative of our second derivative, we're going to get 20 times 3, which is 60, times x to the power of 3 minus 1, which is 2. And then for the last term, we have 12x, and we see here that this is just x. So we can use this rule that I gave you right here, that's something you can just remember. So the derivative of just x is 1, and when we multiply it by 12, we're just going to get plus 12. So that is how you take a higher order derivative, and this is the third derivative for f of x.